The scale and magnitude of the devastation is merciless.
Once in a century flood.
Rescue and recovery efforts underway this midday after devastating floods.
The real reason for the floods we're experiencing? Look around and pay attention, and you can see for yourself pretty clearly. All of the hard surfaces that you see, where do you think that water goes when it rains? We have the mass and massive dehydration and drainage of our landscapes. This is the biggest ecological issue of our time, yet almost nobody's talking about it. And so I'm going to tell you about it, but also how to fix it. And that's with decentralized water retention. It couldn't get more simple. Holding water in the earth, returning it to the ground, can mitigate all of these issues. And there are some truly incredible transformations possible. And just one example, in India, this region, through doing this work, revived seven rivers to perennial flow. Now, why do I say this is the most pressing ecological issue of our time? Well, in reality, we're not going to die from the planet being a few degrees warmer. We're going to die from the flood. We're going to die from the droughts. We're going to die from the fires. And the floods and the fires, they don't care if you're rich or poor. They take everything out in its path. But just in case you're curious, those projects in India also lowered the temperature 2 degrees. So how do we save ourselves from these issues? We help the earth receive the rains instead of reject it. We find ways to hold water, to store it on the landscape, and to help it infiltrate into the ground. The hydration makes lush greenery, and the vegetation cools the environment. So in this way, we can work with water and nature to make productivity in abundance. Now, some of you are saying, wait, hold on. Flooding is a story as old as time itself. And yes, you're right. There are times that long, heavy rains cause waterways to fill and flood their banks. But in the natural state of the landscape, this is an incredibly creative event. The water is distributing nutrients and fertility throughout the floodplain. But what happens in the systems we've created? All of that water is concentrated and sent downhill. Buildings, roads, field drains, river dredging. The water concentrates and the force intensifies. Now smaller and smaller rain events are creating destructive floods downstream. Because instead of being received, this water is rejected. Now the landscape dries out more quickly. It's more exposed to drought and to fire. This is a feedback loop leading to the drying and dying of landscapes. This is the watershed death spiral. But we can also reverse this process. We can harness the power and potential of water and life. We can help the heavy rains be received and stored, infiltrated into the ground. The water revives the landscape, and the vegetation that results can even cool the climate. And so this example in India, they use the seasonal monsoons to rehydrate their parched landscape. They found ways to hold the water on the landscape. Just one community went from 9 hectares to 650 of agricultural production. They've brought water back to 250,000 wells in this region. They've revived seven rivers to perennial flow, and they've reduced the temperature 2 degrees. There are examples like this all around the world. We just need more people to know about them. So to learn about these, join us at waterstories.com.